The Ninoy Aquino International Airport taking another hit to its reputation following reports of a bed bug infestation in its terminals. More from Jackie Pascual.
Ninoy Aquino International Airport makes it to the headlines once again, this time due to bed bugs. One person uploaded a video showing what she believes are bed bugs at NAIA Terminal 3. She says she initially thought they were ants because she had insect bites. Other passengers also posted photos of marks of insect bites after they sat down on metal chairs at NAIA 3 and on a rattan chair at NAIA 2. The airport management quickly addressed the matter.
We would like to apologize for the inconvenience that these two passengers experienced. That's one. Number two, we would like to assure the public that every time that they come over here, we will take, you know, see to it that everything is okay.
Ines is wondering how bed bugs can infest metal chairs, but he vows that NAIA will shoulder medical expenses of victims.
We really have to find out how that happened. I saw the chairs. You know? How can a bug, you know, stay there unless somebody brought it? I don't know.
Ines also assures the public that chairs are being disinfected regularly. However, out of over 8,000 chairs at NAIA 3, only 80 to 120 chairs are disinfected daily because they can't remove all chairs at the same time.
Every day, 20-20 lang ang kaya, binababa sa baba. So, linilinis ngayon doon. Pag linilinis, hindi naman agad maiakyat yun eh. Siguro that's about give and take, overnight pa, sometimes 2 days, kasi nangangamoy yung chemical.
Chairs are sprayed with chemicals to kill the bugs, but it will take a few days for it to be returned to the terminal again. The NAIA Terminal 3 Pest Control Operations Head confirms they have seen bed bugs in the chairs and offers an explanation where they could have come from.
Nakita po namin na halos hindi naman po siya originate dito sa Pilipinas. Kalimitan po, for example, doon po sa mga bagahe or doon sa mga pumapasok sa atin. Possible po is bagahe or yung mga gamit na dala galing ibang bansa papasok sa terminal.
This was NAIA 3 just a few days ago. But on Thursday, many sat on the floor because the chairs were removed.
Baba namin pala dito, nagtaka ako, walang upuan. Yung pala may surut incident. And then, sabi, nakaangalay, hindi komportable.
Mahirap, nakatayo. Masakit sa paa. Siyempre, hindi maganda para sa mga pasahero yun.
The Tourism Congress of the Philippines hopes the incident won't turn off tourists.
Nakaklear up, pero isolated case lang siya. Sana hindi siya maging medyo malaking issue.
Senator Grace Poe, chair of the Senate Public Services Committee, urges airport officials as well as other agencies to regularly disinfect their facilities. MIAA says they will continue disinfecting not just chairs but other areas like toilets. A group of dermatologists, meanwhile, advises those bitten by bed bugs to wash the affected area with soap and water and use cream for insect bites. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
Now, in an interview earlier on Teleradio Serbisyo, the Manila Terminal Airport Authority gave its assurance terminals 2 and 3 are now bed bug free. Philippine transport officials doubling down on efforts to regulate e-trikes and e-bikes. Now, the Land Transportation Office wants mandatory registration for these vehicles and require their users to secure a driver's license before they can use them on public roads. The LTO adds it is now in talks with e-vehicle manufacturers and other experts to examine their safety.
Mariregistro po natin yan, no? Definitely. No? We're just looking for the standards in which they will be registered and determine their roadworthiness. Kumukonsulta po kami sa mga eksperto on how to determine roadworthiness of the vehicle. Ito ay pinagawa sa amin ni Secretary Bautista precisely, no, to get all the inputs of all the stakeholders here. No? So we'll be sitting down with the manufacturers.
The Metro Manila Council earlier passed a resolution banning e-vehicles on a number of national roads in the capital region, citing a rising increase in accidents involving such rides. This regulation is expected to be implemented in April following an information and awareness campaign. Ferdinand Marcos, or President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., back in Manila following his two-day visit to Australia. Marcos called his trip a significant step in elevating ties with Canberra, especially in terms of defense and security. During his visit, Marcos became the first Philippine leader to address the Australian Parliament.
I conveyed to Australian legislators the important role of both our countries as proponents of the rules-based international order and its significance amidst the present complexities in global geopolitics. As democratic maritime nations, access to the global commons, such as the oceans and the seas, must be ensured and safeguarded.
The two countries also inked three deals in the fields of maritime cooperation, cyber and critical technology, and the implementation of competition laws.
Concluding such MOUs will pave the way for more mutually beneficial undertakings, information sharing, and capacity building foreseen to promote closer bilateral ties and also to contribute to regional development, peace, and prosperity. Australia remains and will continue to be one of our closest friends. Our discussions on trade, investment, and security shall inform the next steps in implementing and achieving the enhanced cooperation outlined under the framework of our strategic partnership.
Marcos will be flying back to Australia on Monday for the ASEAN-Australia Special Summit in Melbourne. Several lawmakers reject the president's proposal to synchronize next year's midterm polls with a plebiscite for constitutional amendments. RG Cruz tells us more.
The Makabayan Bloc says no to holding a plebiscite on charter change alongside the 2025 midterm elections.
Ano ba sila hilo? Napakahalagang bagay nitong constitutional amendments. Hindi lang ito basta-basta na isabay. Kailangan pa rin dito ng malawakang edukasyon sa ating mga kababayan at hindi pwedeng parang idadagdag mo lang no, doon sa balota dahil gusto mo lang magtipid.
The Bloc believes that the ongoing Committee of the Whole hearings exposed grounds that can be used to assail charter change before the Supreme Court, from the legality of the process to the merits of the amendments.
Yung mga articles na mahahalaga na tatamaan doon sa unless otherwise provided by law na binabago na sa economic provisions, dapat yon hindi ganun isettle. Kailangan kasi di ba may harmony yon doon sa iba pang mga articles ng konstitusyon.
There's the fear that foreigners can infiltrate sensitive industries.
Ayo, bakit natin din na justify ang pagpasok ng investors by allowing them to control the lifeblood of our country, which is the industries that are most important to the Filipino people.
When we craft the law, we should be able to make sure that there is a screening process that countries which are in conflict with us, I can only see one, and that's China, will be checked.
Colmenares maintains that the Senate does not even have its own rules on charter change. Retired Supreme Court Chief Justice Renato Puno warns charter change advocates said a prolonged court battle on charter change may be a bane to would-be foreign investors. The former Supreme Court chief explains the court won't always intervene. Meanwhile, Congresswoman Brosas pointed out that only a few lawmakers were present by the time the Committee of the Whole hearing ended at almost midnight Wednesday night, even if this is supposed to be a proceeding of the whole House. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.